Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. This is the first part of my create 8 for this month, where I will be creating 8 cards using products from the latest release by my favorite things. For my first card, I'm going to cut out a panel using the stitched rectangle die, and on the inside I'm placing the hearts in a row, which are from this release. I'm going to run them through my Big Shot machine. Now, in the same die set as the hearts, there are a bunch of little tags that you can use with fishtails and without, that I am going to cut out of black cardstock, and I will be using them throughout my cards in this Create 8 series this month. So anyway, I have cut out a bunch, and now my panel is ready to go. I am going to use a red card base, and I'm going to stick this panel on top of my card base by having some foam tape at the back. This is going to ensure that I have the panel a little bit raised. Now, the idea of this die is to have those little tags on top of each of the hearts, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. This is a clean and simple design, and I'm going to pick 3 different sentences from this stamp set. The stamp set is called From the Heart, and it's full of sentiments, perfect for Valentine's Day cards and not only. And I'm going to stamp all the 3 sentences by using my Versamarking, and then I am applying some white embossing powder. As you can see, just to manipulate all those little labels easier, I have temporarily stuck them on a scrap piece of paper. So I can stamp, apply my embossing powder, heat set them, and then they are ready to go, and stick them on top of my card. I went with the sentiments that when combined, you read "My heart belongs to you" in every single way. So it's a lovely Valentine's Day card. I have added some foam tape at the back of those labels, and my card is ready to go. Now, as always, you will find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using down below in the description area if you're watching on YouTube, and also on my blog. Now, let's move on to the second card for today. For this, I'm working on a watercolor paper, and I have my Distress Oxide ink here. I'm just applying a little bit of ink on a piece of plastic packaging, and now I'm going to smoosh that on top of my watercolor paper. I'm not going for a perfect impression here, I just want to have a little bit of color on some areas of my paper. I want to have that watercolor look and feel on this card, so I want it to be very loose and artistic looking. And I'm going to repeat this process until I'm happy with what I have. Now, I'm not going to mix a second color, and I'm not going to cover up the whole thing. I want to have some areas with pink, and most of it I want it to remain white. I have diluted some of the same color with water, and I'm going to add some splashes in different areas. And I'm going to do the same thing with black acrylic paint, just to add some interest and depth on my background. And I'm sticking on a very specific color scheme for this card, so everything is going to be pink, white and black. For my focal points, I'm going to use the Eiffel Tower and a hotel balloon from the In Paris stamp set that has just been released. I'm going to stamp them on top of a white piece of cardstock. Now, I'm using my stamping platform just to make sure that everything is going to be stamped nicely. I'm going to use the new Extreme Black ink by My Favorite Things. This is a great ink if you want to use your alcohol markers. But it's also great if you want to do watercoloring, which is exactly what I'm going to do. So I'm going to put this black ink into test. I'm going to apply some of the same ink that I used previously on my background. This is Distress Oxide ink. I have diluted it with water, and I'm going to color my images. And as you can see, the black ink is not going to smudge or smear. So it's watercolor safe, and it's alcohol marker safe. Now, I'm not going to color the whole Eiffel Tower or the whole balloon. I just want to have a little bit of color on one side. I'm trying to keep this very artistic looking. And then I'm going to use the matching dies to cut them out. Now, on one of the labels that I have cut out in the beginning of this video, I'm going to stamp the word Merci, which comes from the same stamp set. And I have stamped it with Versamarking. I am applying some white embossing powder, and now I'm going to heat set it. So this is going to be a thank you card. I'm adding some tape adhesive at the back of my watercolor panel, and make sure that you add enough tape adhesive so everything lays flat on top of your card base. My Favorite Things has released a new paper pad, which is full of black and white stripes, both diagonal and straight, which I absolutely adore. I think it can be used so much on your cards. It's very versatile, and that's exactly what I will be using. I have just cut out a little strip of paper there. This is going to provide a nice ground for my Eiffel Tower, and then I'm going to stick the hot air balloon on top of my card as well. And I have also secured the Merci sentiment just behind the balloon. So my card is pretty much finished. I'm going to add the finishing touch. I'm just adding some dots here and there with my jewel drops. And this is where I decided that I wanted to add something extra on top of those striped pattern paper. So I grabbed my scalloped edge dies. This is a set of four different edge dies that I absolutely adore, and I'm just going to stick this strip on top of my card. And I know that it would look beautiful if you added a piece of white lace there, but I couldn't find the box with my laces, so I think that would work. Now let's move on to the next card for today. For this I'm going to create a lovely background. So I'm inking up the whole marble background stamp, and I'm going to place one white paper on top of it. I'm using my brayer, by the way, just to make sure that I apply even pressure all over the paper, and I have a beautiful background ready to go. For my focal point, I'm going to stamp one of the monsters from the monster-sized stamp set. I'm going to stamp him with the extreme black ink, and then color him with my alcohol markers. Then I'm going to use the matching dies to cut him out. For my card design, I'm going to cut out a couple of panels using this stitched die. I am going to stick one panel on top of the other, and then that on top of my card base. And as you can see, I went with a bright green card base today. My sentiment reads, "Scream, it's your birthday," and it comes from the same stamp set as the monster. I have white embossed it on a piece of black cardstock, and now I'm going to use these wobblers at the back of this monster, which are going to give an interactive interest, and the recipient can play around with them. I think this is a great birthday card for all your little friends. And hopefully you can see how fun it is to play with it. It's kind of addictive. Now I am going to finish off my card by adding some dots here and there with my jewel drops by Nuvo. And my card is ready. And now let's move on to the last card for today. This is going to be a Valentine's Day card, and I'm using one of the dies from the Be Mine Banner die set. This doesn't actually cut out anything, but it leaves a beautiful stitching detail on top of your card. And I'm also going to run it through my Big Shot machine with the pink cardstock to cut out all the banners. I have spread out the banners along the stitched line, and after I'm happy with the alignment, now I'm going to add some glue at the back of the banners and stick them down. I'm adding glue only at the top of the banners, this way the bottom can be lifted a little bit to add some dimension. Now you will see that later on I'm going to change the idea of what I wanted to do with this card. So after I stuck down all the banners, I decided that I wanted to add the little girl from the Pure Innocence collection. So I'm going to stamp her, I'm going to color her with my alcohol markers, cut her out with the matching dies. I used colors that match the banners and my card base, and I'm going to stick here just in between the two words, B and mine. So it's going to cover up that banner with the heart, but I don't think that it really matters. I am adding some tape adhesive at the back of my panel. I'm going to stick that on top of a card base that is made out of the same cardstock as the banners. Everything matches beautifully, and that is going to finish off my card. So these were all the cards for today. I hope you had fun, you got inspired. Make sure to leave me a comment down below and let me know which one of the four cards was your favorite. Don't forget that I will be back tomorrow with part 2 of Create 8 with 4 more cards featuring products from the latest release. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all tomorrow.